My ideal sunscreen has a minimum SPF rating of 50, a minimum UVA booster rating of 3, water resistance of up to at least 40 minutes, and a non-greasy finish with great ocular tolerance. In this quick review, I'll be going into detail about my experience with Hawaiian Tropic Sensitive Skin Protective Sun Lotion SPF 50. Hey guys, this is Chicks and Patrick of Tips. Welcome to my YouTube channel. As it's written on the tube, the Hawaiian Tropic Sensitive Skin Protective Sun Lotion SPF 50 is fragrance-free, water-resistant, and oil-free with a light texture. It has a UVA circle logo at the front, and at the back it has a UVA boot star rating of 3 and a 12-month period after opening date. There is nothing on the packaging that indicates whether this is for face and body or for the body alone. This sunscreen is being sold in 60ml and 90ml tubes, with the 60ml tube being tagged as for face. The funny thing is that the ingredient listing is basically the same formula for both products, and they have the same retail price of 749 euros. As you can see, the active sun filters here are autocrylene, oxybenzone, and avobenzone. Butyloctyl salicylate is also present to further boost the stability of avobenzone. Maybe this is how they were able to achieve such a high UVA protection with just three old filters. Free radical protection is provided by sodium ascorbyl phosphate and tocopherol acetate. The texture is light and close to runny. It blends in well, leaving zero white cast both on skin and in the hairline area. It stung like hell for like 1 hour plus after I applied it the first time. I took a week off acids, then tried again, and though it still stung, the intensity had markedly reduced and it only lasted like 30 minutes. I'm suspecting oxybenzone as this is my first sunscreen with oxybenzone, but then again, it could be the shitload of plant and fruit extracts at the end of the ingredient list. As promised, it dries down not matte, not oily, but through the course of the day my skin gets oily as I have oily skin. Also, this sunscreen does sting around the eye area, so do make sure to avoid that area. At 8 euros for 90 ml of content, this would have been my latest sunscreen obsession if it didn't sting so much and make me worry that I might be inducing more hyperpigmentation. As always, this is my personal experience as someone with oily but sensitized skin due to high concentration Retin-A usage. Your mileage might vary. Please like or comment or share or subscribe to my channel if you aren't already. See you soon, guys.